Hey everyone, hope you are all having a great day. So for today's video we have IAS Bhude on the channel. He's really good player, better than in every single department. He's showing how to play this Royal Hawk Cycle meta deck in the global tournament.
Ooh.
So I hope you guys enjoyed the gameplay from Budhe's side. It was really great. He's a really good player. And from here on, I'm just showing two of my memorable matches. Mostly I faced random players and random things. And yeah, when you play against a guy with zap, arrows and log, it's really hard to win. So here are just some of the two of the mostly decent matchups, I would say. And I'll just walk you through how to play this. So this Nova Mant guy is actually a really good player. He's got 10 grand challenges win and has a global finish of 900 something. So yeah, he's a high skilled opponent. So I'm just gonna show what my basic mindset was. So important tip here, when you see a lone knight walking in, don't play musketeer to kill it, because there's usually gonna come wall breakers behind it and you'll need a fireball to kill that. So usually if you have bats, then it's okay, because bats are cheaper and you'll have elixir to zap it out and kill them. But when you don't have bats in cycle, just keep your fireball in handy, because you're gonna need it. Yeah, that was a bad zap, shouldn't have done that. So here I'm going in with Prince, because I know his spear goblins and bat both are out of cycle and... So you might be wondering why I'm playing defensive. It's because like minor wallbreaker is such a versatile and strong deck that one or two wallbreakers connect and the entire match turns around. So I'm playing defensive here because I want to maintain the balance of the match. Like I know it has, I have his tower lower and he's slowly chipping away, but I know that I'll get a chance and when I get it, I'll go all in. Yeah, this wasn't the chance, I shouldn't have gone all in. So now very important tip here, I went with bandit wallbreaker opposite lane because his fireball was out of cycle and bomb tower. And that got me the connection and we won. So another thing you should remember, usually when opponent goes in with Trollhawks, I'll play Mega Knight high like that. But you should do that only when it's early in the match and your tower is about 2500 HP. Because in later part of the match when your tower is at 600-500, the opponent can go in to snipe your tower with Magic Archer and you will lose. So you gotta keep that in mind in the later parts of the match. So now that I can see there's a counter push coming, I'll go bandit in the back and play mechanic to the side because there's a high IQ. Yeah, see, the opponent goes in with magic archer. So you wanna play mechanic to the side so that the magic archer does not get damage on your tower and practically gets wasted, because it's all about that damage. If it gets 500-600 damage, the magic archer was worth it. But if it dies easily, it's just a waste of elixir. So again, I could play Mega Knight high because, like I said, my tower is at 2400. That's way too high for a magic archer to bring it down completely. And he doesn't have tornado. So it's safe to play Mega Knight high then. But remember not to play it high when the match is in, like when your towers are very, very low on health. So this seems like a great move from my opponent's side, but it actually wasn't. You see, like, his Mega Knight is gonna get killed on my side, and he just went in with 5 elixir stuff that's gonna create another counter push for me on the right side. So this is my chance. I'm gonna create a huge push that's gonna overwhelm him, and let's see if that works. So as you can see, his overcommitment cost him the match. We broke through his defense.